Before you set up hotel quarantine, your departments and ministers, excuse me, received a letter from the Victorian Government Procurement Board warning that at a time of emergency, and I'll quote, you know, there's a chance of scrupulous or ill-prepared suppliers offering contracts with the Victorian Government, and warned departments to be vigilant. But 3 days later, the Jobs Department let a contract to Unified Security for $30 million. They were not on the vetted list, they were not on the pre-approved list, and this is in contravention with the advice or the warning given by the Independent Procurement Board. Does that concern you?
Well, I'm concerned to have answers to all of these questions and many more. And that's why the board has been set up, and that's why the board is doing its work. And given that that particular security firm was a party that was had legal representation at the board, I think evidence, again, don't quote me, but I understand that there was quite a lot of mention made of that particular company. I'm not making a judgment either way, but I think they were part of the unfolding story and the recounting of what had gone on here. So I'd be very confident that some of those issues will absolutely be in the minds of the board and may well be part of the findings that the board comes down with.
Does it concern you, though, that the Victorian Government Procurement Board required by January last year, so 2019, that all the major departments in the Victorian Government have an independent procurement unit? The only department that doesn't have an independent procurement unit is the Jobs Department. The Jobs Department, you know, is 18 months down the track where they should have an independent unit. They don't. And they were actually put in charge to be the lead agency for critical procurement at this time, in breach of your own government's commitment that everyone would have this independent unit set up by January last year.
Well, again, these matters are, I think, very much under the active consideration of the board, and they will have already and will continue to turn their minds to what, if any, findings they need to make, what, if any, steps they need to recommend.
But your independent procurement board has not given a submission to the Coke inquiry. In fact, when they followed up with your government, they wrote a number of letters to ministers in the Treasury portfolio. They wrote to Simon Femister in September, concerned that the Treasury and Finance submission in relation to procurement went forward to COAT, and they were only told about it after the event.
Well, if you're putting it to me that Justice COAT and her team are not adequately are not in a position to make judgments about that procurement process, then I don't think that's accurate.
No, it relates to the notice to produce that was given to your Department of Treasury and Finance, and that they submitted to the COAT inquiry information about procurement without going to the Independent Procurement Board, that they were told after the fact, and that the Independent Procurement Board wrote to your minister on the 1st of October, wrote to Simon Femister on the 4th of September, are quite exercised, that they gave a number of warnings throughout the year in relation to the letting of contracts, and that they were not then included in the COAT submissions.
As I said to you, I don't think it is accurate to say that the board is not well placed to make judgments about processes that were adequate or otherwise when it came to the letting of contracts.
Why was the procurement board excluded from the COAT
submission? I'm not in a position to answer that. What I'm saying to you is that I think that regardless of that point, this board of inquiry is uniquely placed, having gone through many, many documents and having heard much evidence on this very point.
But they haven't got these letters in their evidence.
Well, that's a matter for them. I'm not agreeing with your contention that the board somehow needs a letter from that agency in order to make a decision about the adequacy or otherwise of procurement processes.
But
they have spent enormous amounts of time.
The procurement board is your watchdog for how public money is spent, and
well,
it's
I don't
not
know
been
that
included in...
No, well, I don't know that you necessarily would describe them in those terms. They've got
well,
many
you've
different...
you've got press releases
they've
from
got many, many different. They've got
watchdog.
Well, if you let me finish, I'll finish. They've got many different roles. I think I've answered your question a couple of times now. I do not concur with your conclusion that the board is not well placed to deal with issues of procurement, the suitability or otherwise of processes, the suitability or otherwise of people who won those contracts. All of those matters have been, I think, that they've been extensively looked at, and it'll be for the board, who I think are well placed, to be able to come to conclusions, or not, as the case may be.
Can I ask Professor Sutton a question?
Certainly.